Now, as internet sensations go, Brothers With No Games is one of the most successful. It's an online channel producing comedy dramas based on the typical lives of young members of Britain's black communities. And they've already reached a million hits. Well, I'm delighted to welcome the founder and the creator, Leon Mayne, and the star of one of his new shows, Elisha Pryce. Welcome to you both. Thanks very much indeed for joining us on Arise News. Leon, I'm going to start with you and talk about Brothers With No Game, BWNG, as it's now known. Why did you feel the need to make this, to talk about young black people's lives, and how does that differ from young white people's lives?
Well, we started off as a blog in 2010 where me and my three friends basically spoke about relationships and dating from our perspective. And when we wanted to make the web series, it was literally a organic growth. It was intended to just to have a show that's creative, something that people will relate to, that's funny. Obviously, one of the major pluses was that it was from a black perspective. So, well, not even that was from a black perspective, but the fact that I had black people on the show and everything that people could relate to with black people on the show, it was never anything that would be too left field or too right field. It's literally four guys going through their everyday lives and people relating towards it.
We get a lot of cultural guests on this program who are involved in the arts, and they talk about the fact that quite often stories featuring black people, their blackness is sort of central to their story, and they're not just doing normal things. Do you find that to be the case, and you trying to sort of combat that in what you're doing?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, the shows that we do get to see on television kind of focus on one side of, I guess, the black experience, so to speak. But we're just trying to showcase content that people would enjoy with black people and showing that we live normal lives just like everybody else does.
Okay.
Yeah.
We should say that's a comedy, and it's been hugely successful, more than a million viewers to that. But you're also branching out. You've got your new program called Agency, which is a bit of a departure. That's also a comedy, and also Day in the Life of Daddy, which is more of a departure because it's a more serious program. We can actually see a little clip now from Day in the Life of Daddy. Let's take a look at that.
You know that guy I'm seeing?
Yeah, Eugene?
His name is Lee. Well, he's asked me to move in with him.
And Tiffany too.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, obviously.
But you're still her father. No man can change that.
I know.
One thing that strikes me about that, very high production values for something that began life as a blog and it's come so far. Just tell me, what's the basic story for that, Day in the Life of Daddy?
Okay, so Day in the Life of Daddy is about a single father called Kwame, and he is reconnecting with his daughter after another man is in his ex-girlfriend's life, and he wants the daughter and the girlfriend to move in with him. And so he's trying to reconnect with his daughter, so there's no tension in between the families, and he doesn't feel like he's losing her to this new family that the mother is building.
Okay, so family tension that many, many people can relate to.
Yeah.
Moving on to Agency, which you, Elisha, star in.
Yeah.
Let's have a little look at that clip. It's a new series too, isn't it?
Hello, my name's Vanessa. I'm not really looking for a lot. It just seems the majority of men I've been meeting just don't match up to my standards, really. I'm looking for someone that knows how to look after themselves, and me, of course, but it just so happens that looking after me requires a few things, that's all.
Now, as that clip would suggest, it's about the trials and tribulations of people involved with a dating agency.
Yeah.
What first drew you to this role?
I do like the character. The character's very, I mean, I think she comes across as quite high maintenance, but what she really wants is, I think, is quite standard. But there is that comedic element that she has a long list of things, and the character is very different to other characters that I've played. I kind of more or less get kind of like bubbly kind of characters, and this one's quite serious, quite straight down the line. So yeah, it's an interesting role.
Have you found that as a woman in comedy roles, you're sometimes the sort of butt of the comedy rather than the maker of the comedy?
Definitely. I do feel like I'm always the person responding to the comedy, which isn't a bad thing, but I do feel like, as you said, as a being a female in comedy, we're never the makers of the comedy. I know there's a big stigma but a lot of people think that females aren't as funny as men, but, you know, that's each to their own. But I have, you know, experience being the person on the receiving end, which, as I said, isn't a bad thing, but that's what I've...
But is that different in this role? Are you more...
So I'd like to say I'm the creator of the comedy, and but this character's very serious, so she's not slapstick kind of comedy. She's serious, but her character is funny.
Okay. And was that a conscious decision in your writing to give Elisha, the character of Vanessa, more comic lines?
Yeah, definitely. I think that we specialise in comedy drama, and our whole thing is we want to make sure that we bring characters that we don't get to see on television and give people roles that they don't ever get to, I guess, take on. So, yeah, it was definitely part of the process in terms of you need to write something that we know that these actors can gain the best out of.
Okay, and dating agency presumably has quite a lot of comedy potential. Do you have real life experience of it? Is this what provoked this?
No, it's just ideas and creativity. I mean, I think Brothers of No Game had a bit of experiences, just a little bit, but everything else has just been an observation, an idea.
Okay, fine. And as I said, the production quality very high. Mm-hmm. How do you come about getting that funding? Because it's a very difficult thing to do, to start off on your own without any backers.
Yeah, well, with Brothers of No Game, we funded it ourselves, and then we did a crowdfunding campaign for season one and two. Our fans were able to donate £5,000 towards both seasons, which is great. Mm-hmm. And we've been able to gain fans who are in the industry, so we've been able to source out DLPs and sound men to help us with the production process.
Do you think that you might find yourself working on more mainstream media? By that I mean television. Would you like to do that? And has this sort of gained the critical mass that it needs to?
Yeah, definitely. With Brothers of No Game, still the license deal with London Life. So seasons one and two are on there, and we're trying to now get all of our shows to be on certain channels across the board. So,
okay.
Yeah.
So great success. That's excellent. And do you know who your audience is for these? Is it just British audience, or are people watching it around the world?
We've been able to acquire a worldwide audience. So we actually have on our YouTube channel 56% UK, 40% US, and the rest made up of Canada, Nigeria, France.
Okay. So, and fertile ground there, potentially, for other series in other countries,
Yeah,
okay, great. Well, very good luck with it. Where can people see? Let's just recap. Well, they can see Daddy, A Day in the Life of Daddy, which is new, out at the moment, and The Agency. Where can they see them both?
They can see on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/brothersofnogame. It's also got Brothers of No Game on there, and a new show called The Loft, which is a discussion panel show on there.
Okay, great. And it's all free, we should say.
Yes.
Okay, lovely. Thank you very much indeed, Elisha Pryce and Leon Mayne. Very good luck with it.